Hey guys, Lazy Man here. Hey, as you can see, I haven't got much done with the cable management. As I started putting this all in the case, I started realizing that I wasn't too happy with the the way the cables came through these holes that we had cut out. If I can show you real quick here. You know, when that comes through the hole there, it only takes up so much space, and then you have, you know, the big opening, you know, around the wires. So I was thinking, there's got to be a way that we can cover up those holes, and here's what I came up with. And I was going to go ahead and do all these, and then run cable management, and then just show you guys. But then, I'm so happy the way that this came out. You know, that I thought I would go ahead and do a little tutorial and show you how I came up with this. So anyway, what we have here is I've came across some 1/8 inch foam, and we'll take a look at the back in here in a minute, but you know, I put a slot in it so the cables can come through. Actually, these down here I won't be using, but just in case, I went ahead and put a slot in it. But we'll take a look at the back of this. Alright, so this is the back side. And as you can see, these stick on pretty good. In fact, let me get set up here and I'm going to show you what I did on this one here. Because I had one on here, and then I thought, you know, be nice if I did a little video on this, so I went ahead and took that off, and we're going to redo it. But anyway, I'll tell you, this was a bitch to take off. I actually had to take a heat gun, heat it up, and then peel it off. So anyway, let me get set up, and I'll show you how we did this, and we'll be right back with you. All right, guys, this is the material we're going to use to make our custom grommets. This is 1/16 inch thick black foam. It actually comes in assortment of colors, but I chose to go with black. Anyway, it's got an adhesive backing that you peel off that is quite sticky. I'm going to show you that here in a minute. But anyway, I was able to purchase this at a craft store here in California. I went to a craft store called Michael's, but I imagine any craft store would carry this. So anyway, they sell this in 16 inch and I believe 1/8 or 1/4 inch. So anyway, let me show you how sticky this stuff is. I got two little pieces here. And I'm going to peel these apart. And I'm just showing you this, guys, because one of them that I did, that I took off without using a heat gun to heat it up, it was a nightmare. Anyway, if I put those two together and then trying to peel them apart, look at that, they just tear apart. So anyway, enough with that. I went ahead and cut two squares the size of the hole that we want to cover up. And let me grab my motherboard tray and show you here. So anyway, I can find my tape measure. You know, I just went ahead and measured the hole. You know, about, you want to go past the hole. So I don't know, 3.5 inches long. And just wide enough to cover it. So about 1 3/8 inches wide. So anyway, I have the two pieces here. The reason why we need to use two pieces is because what we want, if we can bring this motherboard tray back over, you know, we want the foam side coming through, but then again, we want the adhesive to stick to the back of the motherboard tray. So what we use two pieces for is one will be the backing, the other one will trace it out for the size of the hole, we'll cut it, then we'll attach both of these together and then make the slit, and then we've got the foam on both sides. and then the adhesive will be around the circle. So anyway, what I do is take your motherboard tray, take the piece that you're going to be using to or actually the piece you're going to be cutting, and what I like to do is, instead of putting it on this side, if you've made some custom cuts as perfect as we like to think they are, they're not going to be perfect. So that being said, if you were to lay this way and trace it here, when you flip this over, it's not going to match your actual cut. So what you need to do is make sure that you have the foam on the inside of the motherboard tray, and you trace it from the back side. So anyway, you kind of want to just center that up. This one's not too critical, because what you're just looking for is to make sure that you can just draw your circle on there. So anyway, take a pen and just trace that out. All right. So now that we've got that, I don't know if you guys can see it, but now we're going to go ahead and cut that out. And try to, as you're cutting it out, stay on the outside of the line. That way you get a better fit. If you cut on the line or on the inside of the line, it's probably going to be a little small. So we just follow the line around on the outside. Now this isn't rocket science, so I'm sure anybody can do this. So you've got that cut out. What I like to do is, again, do a test fit. We had it this way, so I'll take my other piece. I'll hold that on the bottom. Actually, we're going to flip this over again. So anyway, I'll hold that on the bottom like that. I'll grab my other piece. And with that upside down, I'm going to fit it in there and see how it fits. And as you can see, it's a pretty good fit right there. So anyway, now we can go ahead and put those two together. All right, this is pretty straightforward. You just want to peel this off. Peel the other one off. And when you go ahead and set this on there, be careful again, because as you saw how well these things stick together, if you get this on crooked or whatnot, throw it away. You're going to have to start over. So anyway, just line this up, kind of eyeball where center is, and then push that down. So anyway, now to cut the slot, what I'd like to do is just, again, with my piece, I'm just going to eyeball center, put a little mark on both sides. Then take a straight edge, line up your two marks. And then with a utility knife or some sharp blade, go ahead and cut that slit. And you should end up with something like that. So anyway, now we take the tray again, front side up. I don't know if you're going to be able to see this, but here, let me readjust here. Okay. Then we just want to put this right in there, but again, be careful that you get it where you want it, because it'll stick and it won't come off. Alright, so that's it, guys. Alright, so anyway, let me just show you guys what I else got going on. Let me put this off the side.